Mr. Satya Narayana taking on the first 10 to 15 minutes to educate us on the COVID-19 and post and how we are going to take facilities forward. And to tell you a brief of Mr. Satya Narayana, his name is Satya, and he's a guru in facility management. He's the president of the Telangana Facility Management Council and has 25 years more experience in facilities and administration. And he has postgraduated from Andhra University. So now, Mr. Satya Narayana, can you please take it forward? Hello?
Thank you so much, Michelle, for all your kind support. This journey started with Neetam exactly a year back, more than a year, with the interaction with Chennamareddy Garu, Narendra Garu, and his team, and like you, three people. I'm sure that the way we are slowly progressing towards some sort of productivity from the FM industry, the bridge is already there. Now we are trying to establish a good connection, between the FM industry through 2FMC and then the college of the Neetam College. First of all, I'd like to thank Chennamareddy Garu for always, kind enough to encourage the facilities management industry, and he's very kind enough to encourage TFMC members to be part of the initiative. So I always, it's been a very great inspirational and then motivational person for all of us from the FM industry, because we've been interacting with him for a year now. So we are now, I feel we are part of Neetam, a bit of part of Neetam. So we don't feel TFMC and Neetam is different. So that's a great news from here. So I would like to introduce my team today, who is there in the panel. Mr. Arvind Ramraju, Director of Workplace Services from CTS Cognizant, and he has a very grand experience of more than 2 decades. Arvind, you can correct me. And he has worked in various organizations within the fraternity, with pharmaceutical science. He has a very wide experience into the industry. So I requested him because he's part of the hospitality industry for almost a good number of years. He will certainly throw some light on how do we connect the bridge between the, and how do we help the students of the Neetam or any other MBA or BBA who are part of the facility curriculum, and that's the objective of motivating a lot of students. Couple of sessions also Neetam saying that if you choose the facilities management as your profession, I'm sure there is a very good path. That's what we'll be talking in various seminars or various forums about this. And we also have Mr. Dinesh, who is alumni of Neetam. That's really a proud moment. He was with Neetam and he's completed his post graduation there. And I've been working with Dinesh because he's part of your college and now he's part of the FM forum. So he knows the two destinations and how do we connect the students with the facilities management association or facilities management team members. And the main objective is to develop the skills and absorb the students into the IT/ITS company. That's the main objective. So this is basically about that. So TFMC, as everybody knows, I don't want to take a lengthy session on TFMC. TFMC stands for Telangana Facilities Management Council. Where around 400 plus members are part of this association, who are very actively working for the benefit of the industry. During COVID, I'm sure that now everybody is talking about COVID. I think that COVID is something which now you people are really frustrated to hear the word COVID. But I'm sure we need to go with it. COVID times for next 6 to 1 year, we never know. We started, few of our companies have already started operating, and we are expecting a positive news that, some other companies should also operate from June 1st, based on today's CM's decision. And we are also expecting that around 30 or 24% of companies should operate from June 1st if things are going through. So there is some positivity on the ground that we might operate the offices. That's one point. So how do the colleges operate? I'm sure if the experts like Chennamareddy Garu, sure, they have already planned with the social distancing, with a lot of webinars and all stuff is coming into the picture that we are also doing the same way. So a lot of new things come into the picture. We will certainly work with you for next 6 months on what is the best from the FM industry. We can collaborate to bring the best talented students from your college to the corporate. That's a basic objective. Today we talked about the person on the complete industry. So if there is anything which you feel that, you know, we need something, we are certainly with you on this.
ఊర్లో ఏమైతుంది పని?
Vishal, that is from the TFMC and the introduction of my team members. We want us the
కానీ నువ్వు ఏ పని చేస్తావు? ఏదైనా సగం సగం తప్ప ఓలాడే పని లేదు. తోటి ఏం చేస్తావా? అలా ముక్కలు పెట్టుబా అంటే ఆ గడ్డి పెట్టు.
Yes, sir. Now, Mr. Satya, have you enlightened our viewers on the opportunities which are there for tourism for the hospitality students? How a hospitality student can?
Somebody should use
that speaker. A lot of disturbance. So, like one ground and housekeeping rule which we should follow now is like just take a minute. And let's ensure that everyone are on mute, please. That's a sincere request from our side. So just check your cameras, like everything is mute. Then everyone will... Okay, looks good. Host has already muted everyone. Yeah. I think Satya, you can go unmute.
Sorry for that. What I'm requesting is I want to introduce quickly my team in a couple of minutes. I want to introduce Arvind also and Dinesh also. We will take a few more minutes to introduce and then I'll start opening the session. Mr. Arvind, can you speak? Can you introduce for a couple of seconds?
Yeah, thanks, Satya. Thanks, Michelle. Dinesh. Chiram Reddy Garu, good afternoon. I first of all, it's a great opportunity to be able to connect with a reputed institute of NITHM. Incidentally, I had visited the campus an year and a half ago on Chinnam Reddy Gari invite, and he asked us to share some views on what is it that the FM industry can show as opportunities for the graduating students of the institute. So I was there in a small function that was conducted, and when Satya asked that we should come together and speak about what opportunities and challenges are there in the industry, I was more than happy to join. I have done my bachelor's in hotel management. A quick 1 minute bio. I have done a bachelor's in hotel management from Swain University. I've completed my master's in hospitality management from Griffith University, Gold Coast, Australia. And post that, I started in hospitality industry and gradually came into the FM industry. I spent close to 22 years now and been with Wipro, Dr. Reddy's, and now with Cognizant. Well, we'll speak in detail in a little time to come, but largely the focus lies for someone who is pursuing hospitality. The focus lies in ensuring that the end user or the customer is at the center of all activities that we build in, right? The customer centricity, as we call it. So that's what someone in hospitality industry would look at building their solution or trying their approach or trying to make sure that the overall goal of the services management would happen. And it's exactly the same in facilities management as well. The core of the activity, what we do in facilities, the core of the activity lies the customer. Whereas in a hospitality industry, the customer could be a retail customer, someone who could walk in, he could be a FIT or a GIT or whatever. And in FM industry, largely, the customer is our employee. He comes to us every day. So it's an assured repeat customer. So what do you do for a repeat customer is something that we do in our industry day in and day out. We'll talk about this more in detail. Over to Dinesh.
Right. Good evening, everyone. So good evening, Satya, Arvind, and thanks for the opportunity, Michelle ma'am and Chinnam Reddy garu, and everyone. I'm glad to be alumni of Nitham, and again still have an opportunity to connect back with everyone and share the knowledge which I have earned, the little knowledge. So I don't say it's vast, but like, because everyone are continuously in a phase of learning. So as Arvind told, like as Satya told, the moment I passed out from Nitham, so I had a campus placement from the college itself in Honeywell in facilities and administration. And that's how I started my journey in facilities management. So currently I work as a workplace experience manager for a world leading gaming company. And almost it's 9 years that I am working and like continue to work in the same company so far. So that's a brief experience of mine. And like as Arvind has mentioned about how we treat our repeated employees as customers in FM industry. Just to give a quick brief, which I will finish in just 30 to 40 seconds so that I can, for most of the students or most of them, like if you still go ahead and tell them like I work as a facilities manager or I work as an admin manager or I work in facilities management, I think 40 or 50% people will really understand what you do and rest don't. So that's a fact of the current thing. So like just to tell you like how facilities has evolved over a period of time. So the movie theaters which you go before and the movie theaters which you go today is very different. So the airports which you have been before and what are today are very different, right? The government offices or colleges which you have gone, which you have visited in the past and what you see today are different. So to bring that kind of quality in the environment of an office, of a entertainment zone like cinema theaters, of airports, there is a backbone team which functions 24/7, and that is facilities management. So starting from the way you enter and the way you experience space and the moment until you exit, starting from security, overall upkeep, the cleaning, electrical, air conditioning, everything. So facilities management is a key and a very essential part of any function that today everyone are experiencing. So that's what facilities management is. And when it comes to IT, ITS, like we will talk how it functions and what are the broad opportunities and what kind of skill set that everyone should possess to be a strong leader or a successful employee for future. So that's from my side. Thank you.
Thanks, Dinesh. Thank you so much. Thanks, Arvind, for giving that intro. Yes, Michelle. Over to Michelle.
Michelle, I think you have to unmute.
Yeah, thanks, Mr. Arvind and Dinesh and Satya. So over to you, Satya. Could you throw light upon how a tourism, our hospitality student would actually get a career in facilities? So what are the things they need to brush up on?
Yeah. Thank you. This is the topic which we started a year back interacting with you and the team of Nitham. So the curriculum which we have gone through, what Nitham has published, I think they're pretty close view topics like facilities management on the soft services and not on the technical services. So I think typically that's where I think we said we have opportunities as a front office, and we said we have opportunities with the transport department. And we were also exploring something like cafeteria management and guest relations. There are 3-4 areas which I suggested. That's where I think we started the initial discussion. These are the 4 areas which I thought, and even Dinesh and Arvind would also explore more. I think with their, we had a brainstorming, so they also will give some points. So these areas is which we will start working because we also need a lot of resources now. I mean, post-COVID, we need to see when we're going to operate our offices with full capacity. As of today, we are not operating with full capacity though. Around 30%. So that has to go much further in next coming couple of months. And we need to align with your curriculum and people who are completing their courses and, you know, joining as an interns or, you know, that's what the whole idea. We did one job fair also in Mitam. I think that's what we did. That's one experiment we did, and a lot of people, we got a good response from your team. However, we're also pulling the companies like JLL, CBRE. Last time, we also requested Sodexo to also be part of it, as we are looking the potential with your students. I see these are the 3-4 areas where they can explore more. One is your cafeteria management, which we still need somebody who has an expertise in managing. Now, post-COVID, I'm sure more skills should be brushed onto this department. It's just not like, still we are on a lot of discussions, how do we manage our cafeterias? To offices, to an extent, we are able to operate with your social distancing. We have arranged the seating in a such a way where that, you know, the social distancing is maintained. The reception management is also maintained in such a way that the COVID precautions are taken care. But cafeteria, still we have not figured out. A lot of experts are coming into the forum and saying that how do we bring a lunch pack food. As on today, the IT companies which we are operating with 30% are only getting their lunch pack food and then they're consuming there. So still we don't have much clarity on how do we run our cafeterias, but that's one area where we thought we will groom our students. So still we'll continue interacting with the students who are interested to be part of the FM courses or FM, you know, FM industry. So we'll also go back to the fraternity and, you know, we'll put up a plan. Me, Arvind and Dinesh will put up a plan. How do we connect this bridge? Is it the interns we need to take? Is it the people who are completing the graduation? Is it the people who completed the post-graduation should be absorbed into an organization? So some thought process should certainly, we all will discuss and, you know, we'll have one discussion with your management, with Chidambaram Garu, you, Narendra Garu, and your complete senior management team. How do we connect the dots and, you know, take it forward? That's one point which we need to kickstart post the webinar. And point number two is we also are looking forward to invite a lot of our FM experts from the industry to the college. So this is one of the point of discussion which we had in the agenda. But however, with the schedule, what you know, I'm into or in the college into, we couldn't do much on this, especially this program connecting the FM with the college students. Maybe I think I'll also have one discussion with Arvind and Dinesh to figure out a plan for next 6 months. How do we connect the dots and, you know, more towards some grooming sessions. If we start doing it, I mean, we'll know the caliber of the students and interest of the student. That will make our life much easier to whom to take and whom not. You know, something like, you know, who are interested to come into the industry. Without that, even we do job fair, I'm sure it doesn't give a much results. Is it the point number two, which I thought? And point number three is the regular interaction should happen. And we are also planning to come with a small curriculum on how do we, once the person completed the graduation or post-graduation, can they directly go to a walk-in to our offices? So we are working with a few of the HRs in our industry to say that how many openings are there and, you know, coming back to your desk mission. We need to connect that and, you know, give some, populate some data on how many companies are there to open their doors. So that data is very, very important to you on a regular basis, you know, on a quarterly basis. So that will help you to understand and groom your students in the college and, you know, get ready for your job placements. So these are the 3 points which I thought when we start doing this, all these 3 points, I'm sure that by the last point is certainly we will have a good number of candidates from the college to the corporates. So a program which should continue is a program which starts from the college and ends from the corporate is some ideology which we are thinking about.
Yeah, would Mr. Arvind like to say something on the same? Because I need to actually also tell the viewers that Mr. Arvind has also graduated from Indian Institute of Management, Calcutta, And I would like to thank Mr. Arvind for supporting our students who are freshers, because we have one of our alumni students, Harika, working under him. And apparently she has praised Arvind, saying that he's a very, very good teacher and a good leader leading the team. So thank you, Mr. Arvind. And over to you, if you can just throw a little more light on what Satya said, what would you see the future for these two hospitality trained students in facilities? Because we have a whole lot of other college students also on the seminar today and the webinar today. And they are also looking at a breakthrough. All these students are working with colleges in hotel management only. So it's not only Nitim students on this webinar today.
Maybe some point, Arvind, where, you know, some sort of a plan where we can take it for the next 6 months is also, if we can throw some light, that will be really great, Arvind.
Yeah, certainly, Satya. I think it makes sense. See, definitely there is a need in the industry, right? As Satya has mentioned, and as we all are aware, the need for science-based service delivery is continuously on the rise. Two important topics that Satya has picked up, I'll take a couple of minutes to talk in detail, and then we'll brush upon, right? So Satya spoke about the F&B management, the food and beverage management of cafeteria of corporates, how it is trending currently, considering the COVID situation, what is it that the corporates are doing? So I represent a small corporate in Hyderabad myself. Suddenly one day we got a call and quickly we asked our associates to log off and gave transport for everybody to go back home. And at that point of time, when associates went home or employees went home, we didn't have a clarity in terms of what all would happen by the time the associates come back to office. Now we are bringing people in 5%, 10%, and we are ramping up slowly. But the situation has completely changed over the last 10 weeks or so. The earlier cafeteria, the thronging food courts, the wide range of opportunities we were giving to our associates in front of live show, live counters, buffet counters, salads and juices and ice creams. Remember? So a typical corporate food court looks almost like any of these mall food courts, right? We have a lot of these MRP counters, a lot of live counters, and there are a lot of buffets that are laid out. Food becomes a very, very important point of engagement for our associates. So, and of course, the admin team or the facilities management team runs these F&B operations. So, when we had shut down the office, so to say, on the onset of COVID, and now we are opening the offices, there is a lot of change that has happened in the way one could operate. Right, so there are certain directionals that have been given by the Ministry of Home Affairs. So there are certain guidance that the state government is issuing in terms of GOs. There is certain also guidance that the ACSC is also issuing. What my intention is to say that there are a lot of boundary conditions within which we have to operate, which were not there earlier. Now, in these conditions, for example, physical distancing is a very, very important point to consider. Second is how much of physical contact can we avoid as much as possible between the person who is serving and the person who is receiving the food. Third is in terms of how can we avoid the queues, how can we avoid people standing for food for longer, people coming next to each other or using the same spoon one after another for service. So I'm just breaking it down into transactions so that we can get a clear perspective, Michelle. So that's the intent. So all these are not possible now in the post-COVID situation. So as a simple solution, what are we trying to do? We are making sure that we are cooking food fresh, packing it in retail containers and bringing those containers to office and handing over to associates one after another. It is a quick term, short solution. But it is not a permanent solution. Soon, once after a week or 10 days, a month at the maximum, people will feel this is monotonous and we'll have to find ways to make sure that how will we continue to engage the associates, if not in the earlier format of a long spread food courts, what else can we do to make sure that the engagement sustains? So this is where we need to start thinking about how, what kind of a variety can we bring in? What kind of the menu planning can we do? What kind of a associate engagement can we do? Employee engagement can we do? Try and understand what is it that employee is looking at, both in terms of nutritious food as well as local availability, freshly cooked options, And then how will we incorporate all of them in the given meals options? And how will we continue to do? Will it continue to be a packed delivery? Will it continue to be a restricted seating in the same cafeteria like earlier? Or are we going to completely take off the buffets and keep different retail boxes across different counters? All these are for us to evaluate, measure the success, and then implement. Let's talk about soft services, right? So one big element of our service delivery is soft services, or also we call as housekeeping. Prior to COVID, we used to employ a lot of these housekeeping staff, right? People who were semi-skilled in nature, who were just about taught how to use a chemical, how to use a dilution, how to use a mop, and at the maximum a vacuum cleaner and scrub. That's it. That's what we wanted to do to make sure that the office is clean. We had these janitors, we had these chambermaids. People used to pick up their equipment and reagents and just get going and doing the basic cleaning. Now, when we, after having seen that impact of any surface that needs to be sanitized with certain such frequency, as guided, let's say, by a Virox or Virof or a Buzil or sodium hypochlorite, and not necessarily our existing traditionally successful agents of R6, R1, R2, R3, that's not the model, right? We need to change the whole scenario with which the cleaning has to get delivered. Now, in that scenario, a typical janitor is not sufficient. We need to upskill them and bring them to a level of someone who is at par, and we are actually changing the terminology in a lot of the offices. We're calling them as hygiene custodians, or we're calling them as hygiene stewards. Right, so they are, the custodianship or the stewardship of hygiene is rested with these agents. And these can't be janitors. We need people who are qualified, who can speak the science, who can tell an associate or an employee about what are the right things to pursue when you are doing, when you are managing things, when you are interacting with your infrastructure. What are the right things to do when you are sitting at a workplace? What are the right things to do when you are using your washroom? When you are walking in a corridor, using an elevator, being in a lobby. It's a whole range of things are there. And apparently, we can't just keep communicating in emails. We need these stewards. We need these custodians, the hygiene custodians, in all offices. And believe me, it has to happen in the existing deployment itself. So instead of having janitors around, offices are now looking at taking them to one level up and deploying these hygiene custodians or hygiene stewards in their offices. For example, we are one such company. We are looking to do so. So our existing FM engagement, we are trying to bring people with better skills than that of a housekeeping supervisor, better engagement and better appreciation of the science that is going behind all these new activities that we are bringing up. It's not possible for the soft services expert to be in all floors. So the hygiene custodian becomes a representative of the soft services manager and engages with the associates to tell them what is the science behind. Why are we asking you to wash hands for 20 seconds? Why not 30 seconds or why not 10 seconds? Why are we saying that we have to sanitize your hands every 1 hour? Why are we touching the doorknobs only after they are sanitized? Right? There is a science behind it. And for it to become a muscle memory of associate, for it to become a routine of associate, it requires repeated and periodic counseling to associates also. This activity we intend to get done by experts from at least the basics of appreciation of the science behind it. Also, there is immense opportunities in our transport operations, what we call as the associate commute operations, right? Earlier, for example, an SUV vehicle, for a Zylo or an Innova, we only used to look at it as a 7-seater. That's it. The facility manager's objective was to make sure that the occupancy is maximized. If there are 10 SUVs, we used to target we should get 70 people in these 10 SUVs. Gone are the days. We can't look at occupancy as the prime driver. The prime driver or the prime focus has shifted from occupancy enhancement to ensuring that each associate who is boarding the cab, sitting in the cab, and deboarding the cab is experiencing a safe and hygienic commute, as well as there is no physical contact with one another. So how do you ensure that? Then there's a protocol again that is being built up. Earlier we used to only have chauffeurs and transport supervisors who are only focusing on occupancy. Now again we need hygiene custodians or hygiene stewards there in the transport function also, who will now look at what is the kind of sanitization you have to do on the external vehicle? What is the kind of cleaning protocol we have to do inside of the cabin car? What is the kind of care and diligence that the chauffeurs have to take care so that they don't spread their, if any infection that they're carrying? And amongst the associates who are sitting in the same vehicle also, what's the kind of care that one need to take to make sure that there is no spread happening. So every aspect of facilities management service delivery is now is being looked at a environment, health, safety and hygiene lens. And that gives an immense opportunity for people who are educated, who are willing to make that investment of time and effort in sprucing up their skills and getting ready to be able to learn up and be at the upswing of the learning curve. So if one is ready to invest time and effort and having to ready to catch up on what's happening really at the ground level to make sure that the earlier service management model is broken down and reassembled in such a way that it is ready for a post-COVID scenario, organizations would be more than happy to take them on board is what my view is. And as Satya was suggesting, we can definitely look at a 6-month program in terms of both engagement with associates, making sure that we do our evaluation of the existing skill set, maybe do a little gap analysis if required, and also pick up a path in terms of doing some expert talks with various functional leaders who can come and do a knowledge sharing session, or we can do a brainstorming session or some kind of a hackathon we could work upon, so that students from different institutes who are looking at facilities management as their career path are appropriately at least set up at a level so wherein the prospective employers can see the difference between a prospective employee to someone who has gone through this level of, preempting the requirements and bring them up to speed with regards to what happens here. So that's what I wanted to say, Michelle. Once we listen to Dinesh, let's come back again to discuss more in detail.
Thank you, Mr. Arun.
Thanks, Dinesh.
Yeah, Dinesh, can you continue, Dinesh? Are you here?
Yeah. So what I would say is like what Arvind has mentioned. So in just 2 words, I think it's everyone will call it as the new normal. So it's normal, but it's new. We do everything as we used to do, but with some kind of science and with some sort of a preventive measure. So as Arvind mentioned, yes, the new normal is going to be very different, and it's a learning for everyone. So there is nothing called a successful formula to do something. So it's everyone are learning and everyone are sharing their thoughts. Everyone are just knowing what would be really right at this point of time. And again, like in the phase of learning, like some things might be correct today, might be not really correct tomorrow based on some guidances, because there are a lot of external influences which are guiding, like WHO, XYZ. There are many organizations who are constantly monitoring and telling what is right, what is wrong, and what is successful, what is not successful. And they are asking to try something over a period of time. They tell that like trying this may impact XYZ. So there are a lot of, so this is a phase of learning for everyone. And be it cafeteria, and like now everyone might, or part of this call might be experiencing, if you go to a supermarket and if someone doesn't check your temperature or give you a sanitizer, you think that place is not really safe. So in terms of your memory, that means what is safe, what is not safe is already programmed, right? So that means like the normal, earlier, you might have just walked into a supermarket and like you used to just get in, there were no queues and you just used to go and get things done. But today, if you wanted to go, first, there are some measures like you have to wear a mask, someone will check a temperature and someone will give some sort of sanitizer so that the overall premises is safe. So if we really replicate with an organization, like larger organizations like offices, be it airports, you might be following it in news. So everywhere these kind of measures are being followed. And before these measures are being followed, everyone might have undergone training. So they are not just like that. So everyone might have been skilled on how to use which kind of equipment, where, how, when, and why. So like the future looks like, so what kind of skills that us a student or an aspiring student should really possess is like to have knowledge in areas like where how a new normal looked like and whether I will really fit into the new normal or not. So understanding protocols, understanding the behavioral patterns, behavioral changes. So there will be a lot of behavioral changes in terms of someone looks at us. So like if I walk into an office and if I don't find a sanitizer, I feel, okay, there is no sanitizer. Very first, I'll start looking for it. That means someone should arrange a sanitizer. So the new normal and the future regular workplaces, the future colleges, the future, like the future cafeterias, the future restaurants, a lot of things where their priority earlier was only employee experience. That means how office looked like has changed to how someone can be really safe at and safe in office. Right. So there is a shift. So there is a wave in terms of from an experience to safety with experience, hygiene with experience. So people or the students who are aspiring to evaluate opportunities in facilities management should really dig down and check what are the protocols that has to be followed. What is the science behind doing certain practices and how things are. So they should be really sensitive. So as an organization, every organization is really sensitive today towards their employee health, starting from their home if they're boarding a cab until they go back to their home. So they are really sensitive so that like no one from their organization are prone to any kind of infection. So with that, I think the future is little different, but it's normal. So every student should upskill themselves in these areas for them to grab some opportunities. That's what I would share from my experience.
Thanks, Dinesh. Over to you, Satya. Would you like to throw some light on the same topic which is ongoing?
Yeah. Thanks, Dinesh. I think, as you said, it's a normal life with a new color. I think this is what I think we are all talking about. So we just started our day and ends in the same way, but the new things came into our life, personal life, business life. The way we are working is completely changed from last 50 or 55 days. The way we are staying at home, completely a new experience we are all gaining. One part, Mr. Arvind was also mentioning on the transport, how the transformation should happen. Till we, it's not started, like your transport or your cafeteria or your different facilities management services are going to completely shape out, you know. It's not like normal, you know, it's going to change a wide, we are also doing a lot of brainstorming sessions and to understand how do we really implement this, you know, and a lot of sessions from an employee perspective, still they are not clear how confident they want to come and, you know, work at office, to be very honest, you know, still things are not very clear. We are also working back on how do we bring them, create some confidence. But as an FM industry, we started working on a lot of initiatives at the office, like implementing new technology into the system, like your infrared cameras, or, you know, putting a social distancing into the lifts, you know, putting, starting from your main entrances, you know, we're doing a lot of things, you know, next 1 month or 2 months, we will only do things to create confidence within the industry, you know, that, you know, employees can come and work. If things are all right, the numbers are on control. So on par, as you said, COVID is going to continue, and then we're also continuing our own methodologies to, you know, safeguard our employees. That's one part. And coming to the curriculum, we are also planning one session initially, you know, we should know from the Nitham College, like, when can we do this? So we will be getting prepared with my expert team, like Arvind, Dinesh, and couple of guys who are interested to be part of the classes which we are planning to do, that's the next phase of thing which we're going to come with on a long-term plan basis. I'm sure there is a lot of challenges. I'm sure, I don't say challenges is the word which we are using from last couple of months. I don't say it's a challenge. This part of life, so we will look forward with the students who are interested. I'm sure we have seen the percentage of students who are interested in FM industry. So that's keep growing. You know, when I went last year to Netham College, I remember that of a class of 40, around the 15 to 20 students were very much interested. That's what I personally felt, the interest is good. And the interest is also growing because the organizations are also growing. So the only, the best way is to understand how do they fit into the corporate industry is something which we need to do a couple of sessions, as my good friends were also telling, we will do that. In coming days, next 1-2 months, we will create a plan.
Hello.
Yeah, one second. From an FM perspective, last time we did some classes, and we also groomed them on what exactly we are looking forward as in hotel industry is concerned, or our guest relations are concerned. We did a couple of workshops. I think that workshops will give a lot of new confidence within the students. I think people today who are all watching this show, the live webinar with FM industry experts, I'm sure I want to tell you one thing, that the industry is not going to close, or this is that not the end of the COVID has not created an end, dead end of your career. And still there is some gloom that, you know, it's a matter of fact of a temporary basis for the next 6 months or 4 months, there is a slowdown in the industry, but it does not end here. We are very positive that things might, again come back with the glory of what we had earlier. With the new companies coming up, it might slow down for the next couple of months though, but we need people who, the way the organizations are growing, we also need good students like you who are well-trained, well-groomed. So we always prefer to pick students from hotel management, because if you see today, there are more than around 40 or 50%, I can say, are from the hotel background. The top bosses who are sitting in the FM industry are also from the hotel background. So that's one. There are many inspirational stories which we can bring to you and say that FM industry is the right industry to get into you. Once you've done with your studies, and FM is the next booming industry for the next couple of years. So with this, I would like to pass this to Arvind and Dinesh also, to give some confidence to the students that I'm sure we all talk about the challenges. We spoke a few minutes back. We spoke about the challenges and what the COVID has already impacted us. But now I request both of my panel members to also give some confidence. What does next 6 months looks like, and what is that 2021 looks like? Some light on this will give a wide spectrum to the students who are watching this show.
Yeah, thanks, Satya. Thanks, Dinesh. I think you introduced a nice concept called the new normal. Allow me to share the screen. Michelle, can you enable my screen, sharing the screen? I want to show a slide.
Okay. Just give me 1 minute, Arvind.
Mm-hmm. Yadgiri, sir, can you? I'll call you.
Give us 1 minute, Arvind.
Yeah, sure, no problem. So while our friends help for the technical solution, what I wanted to tell you is that there are two different approaches. At the same time, end of the day, we are trying to do this. That we are trying to achieve the similar outcome.
Arvind sir, please, you can see it. You can share the screen.
Okay. Can you see my screen, guys?
Yes, sir.
See, we put together something. This is to try and explain what is it that the new normal is going to be when our employees come back to work, right? So predominantly, these are the touch points which impact our associates earlier also. How is it that now we'll have more relevance to people with the right approach and right grooming and right skill set is something that I wanted to talk to you about for a couple of minutes, right? An associate is starting from home. Let us talk about the pre-COVID period. He just walks through his car or walks through his cab that comes to pick him up. Can we all go on mute? There's a lot of wind coming from someone. Thank you. So a pre-COVID scenario, associate walks to the cab that is waiting for him. Cab drops him at the office. He or she gets down, quickly comes, swipes in, come to his workstation, locks in for some time, go to the pantry, have a cup of coffee. There's a gym available, there are sleeping spots available, there are indoor games available, there are auditorium and training rooms available. People go and make use of those facilities, go to cafeteria, there's a food court available, have food, then continue with the work, come back, just at the end of the day, close the laptop, pick it up, put in the bag, come back, get into the cabin, come home, right? So largely that was the, so to say, a day in a life in the pre-COVID scenario. Now we think, let us look at it at the post-COVID or what we call as a new normal scenario. Before starting from the office, associate has to check whether he is running temperature, right? Most organizations are now issuing guidelines asking an associate to check whether he is running temperature. If the breach of 99.5 degree Fahrenheit temperature is breaching or not. Okay. Seems like someone's not liking it and they're sharing a feedback about it. That's fine. So post-COVID scenario, an associate starts the journey. So he's expected to check whether he's running some temperature or whether he's displaying some symptoms. And when he comes to the cab pickup, then we remember we spoke about the hygiene custodian in the transport service as well. So the chauffeur explains that associate should enter and exit from the same door. Also, there is a restricted number of people than earlier in a given cab. Then associates come to access the workplace, right? There again, there is a screening involved. There's a temperature screening involved. There's a check of any symptoms that associate is displaying that is there. Once associate comes into the workplace as well, you can see there is a clear demarcation of on the floor or in the work area, wherever it's very clearly laid out. The 6 feet distance has to be maintained between associates. This is new normal. Within the workplace also, there's a very clear, the seats are relayed in any given office, largely making sure that associates don't sit one next to each other, they do not interact very close to each other, and there is no shared facility in terms of a phone or a keyboard or any other infrastructure which is shared by them, which has a risk of taking forward the infection. While there were a lot of facilities earlier, like indoor games, outdoor games, and gymnasia open, now they are closed. So associate has to focus on his or her own fitness by making sure that the right postures are maintained. TFMC has conducted a talk recently by a renowned ergonomist, Dr. Badram. He spoke about a lot of things that we could do while working to keep ourselves fit. Then again, food and beverage, we spoke about just about it a little while ago, wherein currently we are doing a packed food delivery at the desk. But there is a huge scope of improvement there, and we really have to look at how to make it more engaging and more attractive or attentive for the associates to bring. When you leave again for the office, it's not like earlier that you just close the laptop and go. You should make sure that the desk is clean, it is settled, there is no remnants of any of your personal elements on the desk, because immediately after you leave, the cleaning team will come and do their bit of disinfection and make the place ready for the next associate to come and work. And after leaving place and before going home, there is an activity that associates has to really be very careful about. You should only shop from places which are which is confident about. You should not hang out at places which have a lot of crowd. Try and avoid places which are prone for spreading the infection. And just before entering home also, call up and ensure that the door is open before you reach the home, and make sure that you leave your foot, your stuff outside. Sanitize only, then bring inside. So what my intention behind sharing this particular screen is that a lot has changed for both the associate and the way we manage the facilities for them also. And therein comes a requirement, and therein comes a need for people who have a well-rounded appreciation and understanding of what is it that needs to be communicated to the associates, and how will we make sure that the one with the science or understanding or appreciation of what, why should one do a social, follow social distancing? Why should one throw enhanced hand hygiene? One should one follow physical distancing among workplace? So if these things can be appropriately communicated to the associates, it will make our life easy. And for ensuring that the communication happens for some time to come now, we would require people with the right skill set. And that's what I was referring to as a hygiene custodian in my earlier input. Now, coming back to Satya and trying to make sure that what is it that someone can aspire to be? So the whole work spectrum, the facilities management service offering spectrum has itself undergone a very interesting paradigm shift from mere deployment of people by saying, I require 10 housekeepers, I require 10 stewards, I require 10 transport executives. From that model, the whole paradigm shift has now moved, instead of deploying people by number of heads, the kind of deployment that we are currently looking at is, I need someone with skill set who can communicate to associates on the science behind these things. I need people who will be able to explain to my associates what are the requirements that they need to plan around. I need someone whom I can put on floor, who can go to our employee as huddles and explain to them what are the care and what are the steps that are taken by the organization, how we will communicate all of them effectively to the associate, how I can someone can take the feedback and come back to us. And a regular graduate or someone who is not exposed to the rhythm of facility management will not be able to do an effective job here. Someone who is coming with the hospitality management, with the empathy and putting customer in the center of their activity, they'll be able to do a fantastic job here. So it is not that facility management will just create jobs for this skill set. It is such a way, it is poised in such a in a balanced way. It is poised in such a way that these skills are readily available for someone who is coming from a hospitality institution like yours. And this would definitely be in a demand in a quarter or two from now, wherein we will have to now fill in those positions, which will act as a catalyst for all the transformation initiatives that the organizations are taking. At the same time, act as a bridge and bring back the associate feedback back to the management. So that's what I wanted to try and convey, Michelle. Dinesh, you have something to add?
Yes, like as said by Arvin and Satya. So everyone might be curious by looking at a lot of news information that something is going to change and it's going to impact our lives, especially in terms of jobs. And everyone sees that like there are lakhs and crores of jobs which are losing. But always remember one thing, for someone who is really aspiring, always there is an opportunity in a new way. So like the new future always comes with, always in a situation like this. So first it throws us challenges to us or to the society. The nature has thrown a challenge. So, and there are a lot of companies who have made these challenges as opportunities. And like, let's take example. There are sanitation companies. There are a lot of sanitation companies who have evolved within last 10 or 15 days. That means they have seen an opportunity in the challenge. So that way, so like as in next for one or two quarters, most of the organizations will also start learning how to start operating their business in a normal way by equipping all these latest protocols or latest guidelines to keep their employees safe. So while we talk about the latest protocols, latest challenges, so always there is an opportunity for a resource. So like the students or people, staff. So there can be an existing staff or employees, they might be sufficient to handle this, but we need an additional skill set. We might need more number of people because like in the process of de-densification, so like if 10 people are sitting in a room, currently there will be only 3 people sitting in that room and we require 3 rooms for making 10 people sit. That means the size of offices will grow. And to manage such kind of spaces, we need more people. And we need people with skill set, which Arvind has mentioned. And there is no, like, there is nothing called it's going to end and there will not be any opportunities as such, but definitely there will be. From challenges will definitely provide you opportunities, but for someone who really see opportunity, they can definitely take charge of it and upskill themselves, as Satya was mentioning. If we go with a plan and we make, as an institution or most of the students who are part of these calls, like if we look at opportunities, because a lot of people or a lot of everywhere you might be just discussing about challenges and problems, but look at opportunities to solve those challenges and problems, then that definitely gives you an opportunity to either to be an entrepreneur or to work or to excel in FM industry or anywhere. So focus on opportunity to solve a problem. And that is a key, and that is something what every student requires, is what I feel. So yeah, that's from my side.
Yeah, thanks, Dinesh. Thanks, Arvind. I think the roadmap which you showed was slide was very eye-opening. How our corporate offices are going to operate post-COVID, June, July, whatever it is. This is something which, Mitchell, I think this is something which we all thought to speak. And this is not going to end here with the webinar. So that's what the plan is. We have one interactive session with the senior management of your college, with your the director, Chidambaram Garu, Narendra, and the complete team. Talk about a plan, how do we take it forward from here? I'm sure that we are much excited. From the FM industry, we are much excited to interact with you, groom the students, and show the best possible ways what we can do with this current situation. The thought between the college and the FM.
Satya, you have to unmute. You have to unmute.
Hello, Mitchell.
Yes, Satya. You can. We can hear you now.
Mitchell, what I'm concluding here is I would like to thank my team members, Arvind, who has done some rework on how does the corporate operate post COVID. That's a one slider which talks how an employee used to start from work, start from home and reach the office and go back. So it was clearly showing that, you know, that the complete change management happened with the COVID time. And we would also, the request from you is to bring some couple of sessions with all three or all few of us are interested. We'll come forward, create a plan, sit with your management, get a approval, and then we'll start working on a longer plan, on a shorter plan of 6 months and a long-term plan of a 12-month plan. The more the interactions, the more the comfort which we can go back to the management and say these guys are groomed up. The only request I want, request the students, is simply one webinar or one job mela doesn't help everyone to get a job. So you need to travel with us for a long term. And you should understand what industry is looking, the changing industries, what they're looking, and how can you, customize or, groom yourself to the new changes or adaptable changes which are going to take place in the industry from next six months to 1 year. On behalf of all my team, on my TFMC and the complete fraternity, I would like to really thank the management of NITM, the students who are very interested to join this webinar. I'm sure we will take, give more insights on the industry. We keep talking about the industry, how the things are changing, how the things are shaping. We'll keep updating you. And we'll also make you ready for the job which you are looking forward to join the companies, the corporate companies. Chidambaram Reddy garu, I would like to thank you, sir, for giving this opportunity, collaborating with the TFMC and NITM College. So I would like to request you to say a few words about this webinar. What is expected and how do we take it forward?
Yeah, Satya Garu, like I'm just hearing. And from Nitham is concerned here, we are most welcome. Right from the beginning, we are always, wanted you to be part of the Nitham. Like,
correct.
Making this professional, like, our people, like, into getting into the organizations like this year now. And now, when this post-COVID, like, maybe we're expecting the classes will commence from August or September. When the classes starts here, meanwhile, we'll sit together and we'll decide how we want to have this plan for the next 6 months to 1 year, so that you can able to groom the people from Nitham side as per the industry standards, like, what you expect like that. So sure, we'll support our side, and definitely we can take it forward. And on the behalf of the Nitham, I thank you, like, you and your team here, like, for accepting invitation to be part of, this webinar, and, like, talking about how these facilities will take into the future. Thank you very much.
No, my pleasure, sir. My pleasure to you and your team. I congratulate you. And also all the very best to the students and your complete the Nitham teaching staff and the complete staff who have been helping you, sir.
Yes, sir. I think we ask any questions, sir. If someone want to ask any questions, we will open for the discussion like that here now.
Now it's open for questionnaire, sir. You can ask all three of us. We were ready to open for answer the questions.
Yeah, by request, any participant, if they have got any questions regarding these facilities, how it is going to be there in the future, please ask any questions. Or you can write in the chat, the participant, like, chat also you can write there. So that Michelle can able to take it forward.
Principal, sir, unmute. He can unmute himself now.
Michelle, any questions, Michelle? Like, you can able to take from the students? Already taken, or like, you want
to
take some?
Most of the students need to unmute, sir. Even principal needs to unmute. And
no. Do one thing, no. Ask them write in the chat box, no. They can let them write the question there. It is the best way.
Okay. So all participants, yes, dear participants, thank you all for participating today. And you all can mention your questions in the chat box so the experts will answer them. If you need to speak up, also speak up now.
Yeah, one question came from Shreyas More. I think you can able to ask them.
The question, one of the participants, Shreyas More,
What could be the
irreversible effects of the corona of hospitality industry?
The irreversible effects on the corona of the hospitality industry.
Hello, Shreyas. Thank you, Shreyas, for raising this question. I would ask Mr. Arvind to speak on the hospitality industry, as he's an expert in that. Mr. Arvind, can you give some light on this question?
Yeah, so thanks, Satya. So, Shreyas, these definitely are irreversible effects, right? Now, let us look at what it means for the industry in general. As things stand now, there's a huge pressure on the travel. There is a tremendous pressure on the hoteliering as well as the tourism industries as things stand now. Naturally, it kind of is a little worrisome for people who are already employed there or who are aspiring to be a part of the industry. But market will correct itself. We will definitely find better ways and means of adjusting to the change in phenomenon, and it will also be more appropriate for us to make sure that the change in conditions in terms of physical distancing, enhanced hygiene and sanitation, as well as making sure that the practices that are being provided or the guidances that are provided are continuously practiced. We see that the aviation industry has opened up, and to a large extent, the domestic flights have started, international flights are slowly opening up. It might, F&B outlets are open for door delivery. Slowly, the restauranting and banqueting also will open. It might not be at the same level, so that would be irreversible. The kind of volume that was catered to earlier might be not possible in the immediate future. But that also means that there is an opportunity for newer and smaller places or more targeted places to open up and look for revenue generation or engaging opportunities. One more element we can definitely look at is that while the entry threshold for someone to get into hospitality industry was very low. Just about anyone could be a professional, anyone could enter the hospitality industry earlier. With the enhanced protocols and with the enhanced requirements and a little bit more stringency in accepting it, the entry threshold itself will raise and there will be the bar would be raised for people to get into the industry itself. So it's a good news for people like you who are all trained, who have the right credentials. The market will actually look forward to people like you who have both the academic as well as the credentials in terms of approaching it in a scientific manner. So that is one change that I can think of right away. There will be a reduced volume, there will be a reduced demand, but that does not mean that necessarily that these businesses will go out of the market. We will find better ways, we will find engaging ways, and we will find ways which are suiting to the change paradigm, and still everything will continue is what I strongly believe in. So that's my answer, Satya.
Thanks, Arvind. Thank you so much.
Thanks, Arvind.
I have a question here, Michelle. Can I put it?
Yes, sir, you can put it.
Hi, good afternoon, Satyanarayan Garu. Hi, Arvind and Dinesh.
Hello.
Good evening, sorry. Good evening.
Hi,
Narendra. Yeah, nice. A lot of information on this platform you could hear. Now, the question basically is about, a lot of facilities, companies, staffing has been reduced to 30%. That's what we hear. The question is the volume of space is remains same? It is 30% occupancy. Of course, if it is as usual like pre-COVID situation in terms of space, that means the opportunities per facility management is going to remain same. And further the students to get into these facilities, what kind of knowledge they should acquire more with the current situation? What is the sanitation standards? Who is the facilities? They should study in the college. Probably one of the speakers can throw light on this subject. Thank you.
Yeah. From a space perspective, it was not a constant decision by the company to make work from home 80% or 20% or 70-30 is what it's going today. Because of the COVID, there is no clarity on how do we operate. I'm sure the space today, people are retaining the spaces because there is no concentration or a vision for next 3 months. So everybody is holding on the spaces. So might be, as I said in the earlier conversation, the fit out or the constructed projects might go a bit slow. Instead of starting in June, they might start in October, November. That's going to happen though. That's one point. The other point is bit slowdown for next 2 months on the hiring numbers. So there are companies still they are hiring, which is not coming to the media. But there are companies from a work from home also, we need, there are projects which are demanding that we need people to work. So that's the positive flip that, things are going good. The other flip, things are not good. So I recommend that we need to wait and see for a month or so, because that's what the whole industry is watching. What looks like the June and July looks like. So that is something which the hotel industry, the aviation industry, the aviation industry is good that they already started resuming. The IT industry has also started working with 30% from May 11th is something which we started. That was the government clearance was given. Things seems to be more of a speculation that, what will happen. So I suggest that, we need to wait for some more time to give a clarity on the numbers or the growth plans for next 6 months. So that is one point, Narendra Garu, which we want to wait and watch strategy, which
thank you. Next part, how the student should get equipped to handle that kind of jobs with the pandemic, post-pandemic situations?
Sorry, sir, what is the question?
Yeah, how the students in terms of curriculum knowledge, they should be equipped to, you know, as a ready to go talent in the facility management company.
No, I think this is the right time, as most of the people have practically seen that you have a lot of leisure time at home. So people started grooming their own skills. So, and you have, I'm sure for the students, you will have a lot, you know, responsibility are less, and people have a very quality time to learn things. So we can give some, workbooks, or we can also give some thought process on the facilities management, and they can actually get understand in next couple of months, because I'm sure we might not really open the doors for the colleges, or we might not open the doors for people to travel. So some ideology on the facilities management, on the key interest, if they are looking forward for hotel management, I'm sure some learning, some videos which can help them to understand about facilities management. I recommend them to go through that. We also can share some content which we all go through on the facilities management, which will give a better understanding in a couple of months, and then they can join back in the project what we are planning in August or September. So that's the stopgap. With next 2 months, people can still learn from their home.
Yes.
With the content what they have on hand, what is available on the internet, and what the data which on the facilities management, we also can share some good insights or the PPTs or some presentations on to groom them.
That's any new protocols which are coming part of the facilities, if you can share, probably we can also add them to our...
We'll do that. Yeah, we have done a lot of rework has been done, on terms of on the protocols we have done it. How do we maintain reception? A while ago, Arvind Garu was also sharing a protocol or a document which talks about an employee starting from a home laptop. So there are a lot of things which we created on hygiene perspective. Also, a lot of protocols we created in the offices. How do we maintain cafeterias? How do you maintain our offices? We can share that. There is no restriction in sharing that, which people can understand better within their leisure time.
Yeah. Thank you.
Sir, Michelle, yes. Can you take the questions from the chat box actually?
Yes, sir.
There are a couple of questions out there from chat box. Can you take that?
Yeah, I'll take that, sir.
Satya,
there were a few questions here. One of the viewers are asking about what would the... 1 minute, I'll just read out the question here. It says, good evening, sir. What are the job opportunities for students passing out this year in facilities?
Dinesh, would you like to answer that?
Yes. So, as I mentioned in our previous discussions or conversation in this session, so always as an organization, most of the organizations are still continue to recruit people with e-interviews, and they're onboarding people. So recruitment and all this have not really stopped.
Correct.
So that's still continuing. So a lot of people are not really accessible to this information. So recruitments are going on, people are being onboarded, everything is just going normal in a digital way. So, but what we get to know from media and most of the other sources are nothing is really working. So that might be correct to an extent, but largely in IT and ITS where people really work on technology, things are going more or less normal and people are adapting to it. So in terms of opportunities, so just to say, to be a little optimistic, things might not be really quick the moment you finish your semester by August or September, but things may be a little delayed. But definitely, we are hoping that the future is a little confident. A future is always promising. So that's what I believe. And there are opportunities. There are space requirements coming up. There are new changes which are coming up in in the market, being it an aviation industry. So earlier, to follow all the same protocols and operate an airport, we might require 15 or 20 more employees to run an operation when compared to old model. That means there is an opportunity for recruitment, right? So with following all the protocols given by WHO to run an airport, we might require more staff. So that means there is opportunity waiting there. Only thing, we just have to be a little sensitive of how things are going to be. There will be opportunities, just we have to wait, but they may be a little delayed, but always there are opportunities. So that's what I would say. Like, is there anything you can add, Satya, to it?
Correct, correct. That's great, Dinesh. I think if it is answered or not, I think we should ask the
one who should. Yeah, so is it like, is it fine? Like, are you convinced with the answer, or let me know? So
yeah, sure.
Yes.
Next, any questions?
I think that's it. Most of the same question more or less has been asked by many students. So I think you've answered it well. And as we said, we have to look at the opportunities. And any more questions from our viewers? So I think we bring this lovely session to an end, the webinar. And I thank, on behalf of the director and principal of NITIM, I thank our speakers, Mr. Satya, Arvind, and Dinesh, for joining us today. It's been a wonderful session, and I'm sure our viewers and participants have enjoyed it too. So thank you so much.
Thanks, everyone.
Thank you, Michelle. Thanks, Satya. Dinesh.
Thank you.
Pradi Garu, Narendra Garu, thank you so much. Have a great evening.
National Institute of Tourism and Hospitality Management, nurturing excellence, serving success.